Hi everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about azathioprine. What is this drug azathioprine? This drug is classified as antimetabolite. Since this drug is going to be converted into false nucleotide and inhibits the DNA synthesis, it is classified as antimetabolite. And particularly azathioprine is used as immunosuppressant. During the organ transplantation, this drug can be given in order to suppress the immunity of the host in order to prevent the organ resection. Similarly, this drug is also used as anti-inflammatory agent. Particularly, inflammatory disorders like rheumatoid arthritis and other inflammatory conditions can be treated by azathioprine. But actually, azathioprine is an inactive drug and it is considered as prodrug. So, in vivo, azathioprine is converted into one of the active metabolite 6-mercaptopurine, which is mainly responsible for all the pharmacological activities of azathioprine. So, today in this video, we are going to discuss about how this azathioprine acts, what is the metabolic pathway, what are the important precautions, interactions, side effects, and clinical use of this drug. We will discuss in this video. So, azathioprine is having two types of activities. First one, it is used as immunosuppressant. So, this drug is used to prevent renal transplant resection. In such situations, azathioprine can inhibit the T cell activity. Thereby, it can suppress the immunity of the host, which facilitates organ transplantation. Similarly, this drug is also used as anti-inflammatory agent. This drug can be used in the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis, as well as other inflammatory bowel disorders such as Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis. In all these conditions, azathioprine can be used. Now let us see the chemical nature of this azathioprine. So this is the structure of azathioprine. We can clearly observe it is having the purine ring system. So this is a purine ring which is attached with a mercapto group. Now let us give the numbering to this purine ring. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Numbering of purine ring system is unique. Now the mercapto group or thio group is attached at 6th position. That's why azathioprine is the derivative of 6-thiopurine. And here we clearly observe that within this thiopurine, if we remove the U, it gives the suffix of the name thioprine. Thioprine indicates it is a thiopurine derivative. So, if we write the chemical name of this azathioprine, it is nothing but 6-thio-1-H-purine. Now, at the 6th position, it is having another heterocyclic ring system, that is nothing but the imidazole ring. Let us give the numbering to this imidazole ring. So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, this imidazole ring is attached by 5th position. So, we can write this as 1-H-imidazole-5-aryl. This imidazole ring is having further side chains, first position methyl group and fourth position nitro group. So that is the complete name of azathioprine. Now let us see how this drug acts. Azathioprine can enter into the cells where it is going to be converted into its active metabolite 6-mercaptopurine. This 6-mercaptopurine is then converted into another metabolite 6-thioinosine monophosphate. And this step is mediated by one of the enzyme HGPRT, hypoxanthin guanine phosphoribosyl transferase. By this enzyme, it is going to produce a 6-thioinosine monophosphate, which is mainly responsible for anti-metabolite activity. Now, 6-thioinosine monophosphate can inhibit DNA synthesis, as well as it can inhibit the synthesis of IMP, thereby purine synthesis is going to be inhibited. So, this is the structure of azathioprine. This is a prodrug and it is going to be cleaved at this position such that it is going to produce the 6-mercaptopurine. Now, this azathioprine can be converted into 6-mercaptopurine and this step is mediated by one of the enzyme glutathione S transferase, where whatever the imidazole ring attached to the sulfur group is going to be transferred to the glutathione, such that it produced 6-mercaptopurine with free thiol group at the 6th position. Now this is the another form of this 6-mercaptopurine. Now this 6-mercaptopurine can be converted into another metabolite. This is 6-thioinosinic acid, and this step is mediated by one of the enzyme HGPRT, hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase. By this enzyme, now it produces 6-thioinosinic acid, which is mainly responsible for pharmacological actions of 6-mercaptopurine. So here 6-mercaptopurine is converted to 6-thioinosinic acid, which is also called as 6-TIMP, 6-thioinosine monophosphate. And this step is mediated by the enzyme HGPRT. And then this 6-thioinosine monophosphate can inhibit IMP, inosine monophosphate, which is actually converted into AMP, adenosine monophosphate, as well as XMP, xanthine monophosphate. In this way, the 6-thioinosine monophosphate is going to inhibit purine biosynthesis. Similarly, this thioinosinic acid can be further converted into thioguanines. Initially, it is converted into 6-thioxanthine monophosphate by one of the enzyme IMP dehydrogenase. Then it is going to be converted into 6-thioguanine monophosphate by another enzyme xanthine monophosphate aminase. And finally, these thioguanines can be incorporated into the DNA, where they are not functioning like purines. So they are acting like false metabolites, thereby they inhibit the DNA synthesis. Now let us see the metabolism of azathioprine. We have already discussed that azathioprine is going to be converted into 6-mercaptopurine, which is the active metabolite of this drug, and this step is mediated by one of the enzyme glutathione S transferase. Then this 6-mercaptopurine is going to be converted into 6-thioinosinic acid by one of the enzyme HGPRT. So this is the bioactivation of azathioprine, which lead to formation of active metabolites. Thereby, it inhibits purine synthesis as well as DNA synthesis. But here, 6-mercaptopurine can be inactivated by other metabolic pathways. One of the important metabolic pathway is that the 6-mercaptopurine can be converted into 6-thiouric acid by one of the enzyme xanthine oxidase enzyme. Similarly, the 6-mercaptopurine can be converted into 6-methylmercaptopurine, where methyl group is attached to the free thiol group by one of the enzyme TPMT, thiopurine methyl transferase. Since azathioprine is a thiopurine, to this thiol group, a methyl group is transferred by this enzyme thiopurine methyl transferase. And interestingly, this TPMT shows some genetic variation. And in few of the patients, this TPMT activity may be low, which may lead to less metabolism of the azathioprine. So before administration of azathioprine, the TPMT phenotype is to be assessed in order to fix the dose of azathioprine. In the patients who are having the intermediate TPMT activity, the metabolism of azathioprine will be less, which may lead to increased risk of myelotoxicity. Similarly, in the patients who are having low TPMT activity, the metabolism of azathioprine is further suppressed, which may increase the severe life-threatening myelotoxicity in the patients. So before administration of azathioprine, TPMT activity should be assessed. Otherwise, it may lead to severe bone marrow depression in the patients. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of azathioprine is that this drug can increase the bleeding as well as increased bruising in the patients. So easy damage as well as easy bleeding can be observed in the patients. And in the patients, we can observe severe bone marrow depression, which may lead to leukopenia, decreased leukocyte count, and thrombocytopenia, decreased thrombocytes. These two are more important, and the patients who are treated with azathioprine may have increased risk of bleeding. Similarly, this drug can also produce pancytopenia as well as macrocytic anemia. So that's why whenever this drug is going to be prescribed, the complete blood count CBC test should be done frequently in order to assess any hematological disorders in the patients. So this CBC test should be done for every 1 week within the first month of the treatment. And after that, the CBC test should be done twice a month and once a month. in order to assess any risk of blood disorders. Another important precaution of azathioprine is gastrointestinal hypersensitivity. This drug can produce hypersensitive reactions which are related to gastrointestinal system. It can produce few of the symptoms such as nausea and vomiting, diarrhea, skin rashes, fever, malaise, decreased energy, myalgias, muscle pains, hypotension, and elevation of liver transaminase enzymes, which may indicate some hepatotoxicity. All this can be observed with azathioprine because of hypersensitivity. So any hypersensitive reactions are observed in the patients, then this drug is contraindicated. Similarly, this drug increases the risk of malignancy. So it can produce some lymphomas, myelogenous leukemia, and even it can produce skin cancer. And particularly, in order to prevent the skin cancer, the patient should avoid direct exposure to the sunlight. Another important precaution is that this drug can increase the risk of infections. Since this drug is an immunosuppressant, it can suppress the immunity, which may increase the risk of infections. So patient treated with the azathioprine may have some bacterial as well as fungal infections. And even viral infections are also increased with this azathioprine. Now let us see the drug interactions of azathioprine. Cotrimoxazole is one of the antibacterial agent, which is a combination of sulfamethoxazole plus trimethoprim, which is used to treat urinary tract infections. This drug can produce some leukopenia in the patients. Similarly, AC inhibitors like enalapril, ramipril, all the drugs ending with the pril can also increase the leukopenia. So when these drugs are combined with azathioprine, it can further increase the leukopenia in the patients. So these drugs should be carefully combined, which may produce some blood disorders in the patients. Similarly, anti-inflammatory agents such as sulfasalazine, mesalazine, olsalazine, all these drugs are aminosalicylates, which are used to treat inflammatory bowel disorder. And these drugs can inhibit the activity of TPMT, thiopurine methyl transferase enzyme. So when this enzyme activity is inhibited, it can reduce the metabolism of azathioprine, which may increase the activity of azathioprine, leading to myelosuppression in the patients. Another important drug interaction can be observed with allopurinol. Azathioprine is converted into 6-mercaptopurine. This 6-mercaptopurine is converted into 6-thioinosine monophosphate. We have seen this pathway. Now this 6-mercaptopurine is going to be metabolized to 6-thioxanthine initially, and this step is mediated by one of the enzyme xanthine oxidase. The same enzyme is also responsible for further conversion. Now 6-thioxanthine can be converted into 6-thiouric acid by the same enzyme xanthine oxidase. So allopurinol is one of the anti-gout agent, which is a xanthine oxidase inhibitor. So when this drug is combined with azathioprine, it can inhibit the activity of xanthine oxidase, thereby it can inhibit the metabolism of azathioprine, which again leads to increased toxicity, leading to bone marrow depression. Now let us see the side effects of azathioprine. Most of the side effects are related to hypersensitive reactions, otherwise hematological disorders. So this drug can produce few of the side effects such as nausea, abdominal pain, vomiting, diarrhea, fever, skin rashes, and malaise. It can also produce leukopenia, thrombocytopenia, as well as some anemia in the patients. And hepatotoxicity, elevated levels of transaminase enzymes can be observed in the patients treated with azathioprine. It can produce myalgias, muscle pain, hypotension, alopecia, loss of hair, as well as at high dose, it can produce lymphoma as well as leukemia in the patients. How it is given? This drug is available as tablet as well as dry powder, which is available for IV solution. And the dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication as well as the activity of TPMT within the patients. As an immunosuppressant, this drug can be used to prevent rejection of renal transplantation. So for renal transplantation, the initial dose of the drug is variable from 3 to 5 mg per kg per day. Similarly, for the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis and other inflammatory disorders, the dose of the drug is variable from 50 to 100 mg daily. and the dose may be increased as 0.5 mg per kg for every 1 week based on the efficacy of the treatment. So that's about this azathioprine. Azathioprine is an antimetabolite, and actually this drug is a prodrug of 6-mercaptopurine. Since this drug is a thiopurine derivative, it is having the suffix thioprine, and this drug acts as immunosuppressant as well as anti-inflammatory agent. Due to its immunosuppressant activity, it can be used to prevent rejection of renal transplantation. This drug is used to treat the signs and symptoms of rheumatoid arthritis, Crohn's disease, and ulcerative colitis. In vivo, this drug is going to be converted into 6-mercaptopurine by the enzyme glutathione S transferase. Then this 6-mercaptopurine is converted into 6-thioinosinic acid by one of the enzyme HGPRT, hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase. This thioinosinic acid can inhibit the purine synthesis, as well as it can be converted into 6-thioguanines, which are going to be incorporated into the DNA, thereby they inhibit the DNA synthesis. The 6-mercaptopurine can be inactivated by two important metabolic pathways. One of the pathways is the xanthine oxidase pathway, which is going to be blocked by allopurinol. Similarly, another pathway is mediated by one of the enzyme thiopurine methyl transferase, which shows some genetic variation in the patients. So in the patients with low levels of this enzyme, results in the increased levels of azathioprine, leading to higher risks of myelotoxicity in the patients. So this drug produces bone marrow depression, which may lead to increased bleeding, thrombocytopenia, leukemia, and even macrocytic anemia. And this drug can also produce gastrointestinal hypersensitive reactions, which should be closely monitored. Increased risk of infections due to immunosuppressant activities and the important precaution. And this drug at high dose, it can also produce malignancies such as lymphomas, leukemias, and even skin cancer. So the patient should avoid direct exposure to the sunlight when this drug is going to be prescribed for longer periods. Along with cotrimoxazole and ACE inhibitors, it can increase the leukopenia. And with aminosalicylates like sulfasalazine, mesalazine, olsalazine, this drug may have increased risk of myelotoxicity due to inhibition of TPMT activity. Allopurinol can also increase the toxicity of this drug by inhibition of xanthine oxidase activity. And this drug is available as a tablet as well as dry powder for IV solution. The dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication. For renal transplantation, it is given at 3 to 5 mg per kg per day. For rheumatoid arthritis and other inflammatory disorders, the dose is variable from 50 to 100 mg per day. So that's about this azathioprine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.